The number one question that I'm asked everywhere I go around the world is always, how is it that I stay so motivated? What are the motivating factors in my life that keep me in this psychological space? Number one will be gratitude. I try and find a way to be grateful for every single thing I have every single day. Wins, losses, loved ones, you name it. My life wasn't always this way. It was much different many moons ago. So these days I'm grateful to the bone for everything. The other thing is hunger. You always hear people say, well, it's about being number one, about being at the top. Or how about this? You're always going to find somebody out there who's going to work harder. Well, I don't know that. That might be bullshit. But I know no one is going to be hungrier than I am. And I try and find a way to be grateful. So I hope that helps. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. If you're watching this, you better be doing something productive today. Very intense workout, hardcore, very heavy. Creating and destroying, breaking down and building up that very dense, thick muscle. We always talk about hunger and how you always want to outwork your competition regardless of how successful you may be lucky enough to be. You want to be hungry. If you know what it's like to be hungry, you'll never be full. He said it's one thing to be hungry, it's another thing when you're starving for greatness and starving for success. And I love that because it immediately clicked. It's in my DNA. I know what it's like to operate every single day, regardless of the success that I've been a lucky son of a bitch to achieve. I operate every day as if I'm starving, so keep starving.
At 4 o'clock in the morning is when no one else is up, so no one else is bothering you, and you can focus on whatever work you have to get done. And then by 4:30, 4:45, I'm doing some sort of cardio. It's still dark outside, so it's just me.
It's 4:45 a.m., it's still dark outside, and I'm getting ready to kill this AM cardio. You can't even see me, but it's gonna be so good, it's bad.
I do this and then I'll have breakfast and then I will go do all my strength and conditioning training at a gym for about an hour and then I'll go to set.
It's midnight, I'm on my honeymoon and I'm in here working out. Saturday night, 1:45 a.m. I just wrapped a phenomenal workout here in the Iron Paradise, got after it hardcore. Hardest workers in the room. We just wrapped here in the Iron Paradise, another great workout. Iron ain't gonna kick its own ass, you gotta get after it, let's roll. You reach that point, you know, we all reach that point where we're training. And you break through to the other side. You break down barriers, you bust through ceilings, you knock down doors. That just happened for me. It's very defining. I've been slinging iron since I was 13.
Our empty gym, the way we like it. It's Sunday, it is family day, it's Lord's day. It is also leg day. So this pain ought to be fun. Shit, happy Sunday.
And in the moments where you push yourself, when no one else is around, those moments have a tendency to lead to success.
Focus!
Up for 26 hours straight. 7 hours ago I was in LA, and now I'm down here in hot ass Florida. I'm heading to the set of Ballers, but first I had to come here to the Iron Paradise, anchor myself, get the workout in. It's gonna allow me to work an additional 12 hours. Point is, I'm still tired as a motherfucker, but find your anchor. I'll see you on set.
All right, Saturday afternoon, empty gym, the way we like it. It's leg day, which means it's gonna be sweaty, painful, and fun. All right, workout number two. I'm out working all my competition.
We are getting after it hard and heavy here in the Iron Paradise.
And we're here in the West Coast Iron Paradise. All right, empty gym. The way we like it. Getting ready to get after it.
Saturday evening here at the Iron Paradise, we are getting after it hardcore and heavy.
I get to the gym determined, focused.
Here at the Iron Paradise, we're getting after it hard and heavy, training legs.
Friday night, empty gym. The way we like it.
Focus!
Welcome to hell on a Friday night. All right, just worked a 12-hour day. Well, 13-hour day, but who's counting? Empty gym, the Iron Paradise. This is my therapy. I encourage everybody out there to find your therapy. All right, Friday afternoon, clanging and banging before I got to go into work to shoot. I went one-on-one with something. Not a dumbbell, but all the dumbbells. It's called running the rack.
All right, just wrap that 4 a.m. cardio. There's no substitute for hard work here in the garage of hell.
All right, good to be back home here in Florida at the Iron Paradise. It's about 100 degrees here. Today afternoon down here in the swamplands of hot ass Florida, here in the empty gym, the Iron Paradise. Empty the way we like it. Just finishing up leg day, heavy leg day under this vertical leg press. All right, here we are, 4:45 Saturday afternoon, the Iron Paradise. The gym is empty, just me and Tupac on the speakers. I'm getting ready to pull myself through hell with this leg workout. If I don't make it back alive, someone take care of my baby. All right, here we are in the Iron Paradise, down here in hot-ass Florida. Swamplands out there where the alligators roam so free. I'm about ready to get after it. I'm going to be the baddest son of a bitch in this gym. True, I'm the only dude in the gym. Doesn't matter. Get after it. Right outside these garage doors, it is 97 degrees out there. It's hot as hell. Jim, it's the second coming of hell. We're getting after it hardcore, clanging and banging. Sometimes your vision is so big, you don't know how you're going to get there, and that's okay. You don't have to have all the answers. Keep that vision clear, your eye on the prize. I got no sleep, off the jet, came right here to the West Coast Iron Paradise. In about 5 minutes, this place is going to be cranking, and I'm going to get it on. I heard something, though, that I wanted to share with you guys as we all look to finish our week strong on this Friday. A buddy of mine named Inky Johnson on Instagram, you should follow him, he said, perspective always drives your performance. And I love that, and it's so true. Look, I'm tired, you're tired. I got a baby at home, she's gonna wake up in an hour looking for daddy. I got a baby mama at home, she's gonna give birth any day to my third daughter. I got Rampage opening worldwide, I got a lot of business to take care of. But I thought, instead of going to sleep, let me come to the gym, get my workout in, and clear my mind so I can attack the day. Again, perspective always drives your performance. Think about that, apply it, and finish strong. Don't ever confuse effort with results. We gotta give the effort. At the end of the day, the only thing that matters is the results. So give the effort and always stay focused on the results. Happy New Year. It is January 1st. We are kicking off this new year, 2018. Very strong. Just finished leg day.
The work never stops. You always gotta keep going. Always.
I go hardcore when I train. I don't have time to go to the bathroom. I find a bottle, I pee in it, and I keep training like a beast. It ain't about being the biggest and the baddest. It's about a mindset to be the best. Outwork your competition and dominate at what you do. So somebody just asked me a cool question, said, DJ, you're on top. Where could you possibly go from here? And you always talk about outworking your competition. Who's your competition? It's a great question. Thank you for the compliment, by the way. I'm fortunate enough to be on top, but anytime you reach the top, you always want to make sure that you have the desire to raise the bar and take the brass ring to places it's never been. That's the key with being on top. Just because it's never been done doesn't mean it can't be done. And in terms of competition, great question. Everyone's my competition, but a fundamental key that I've learned over the years is, and I'll share it with you, my number one competition is me. It's always you versus you. You got to be the one to get up every morning, be disciplined, put in the consistent daily hard work, because that gains success. No coach, no trainer, no mentor, no boss can do it. You versus you.
Focus!
Always be the hardest workers in the room. And it's just a reminder that regardless of how successful we may be or how successful we're not, but we want to be, we always want to be the hardest workers in the room. It always leads with hard work. There's no substitution for hard work. Thus, working out at 11 o'clock at night when I know my competition is asleep.
No matter how many hours I've flown, no matter how many miles we've traveled, regardless of what country it is, the first thing I need to do to get ready for the workday is I gotta find the gym.
You have worked your ass off, and you are lucky and fortunate to be number one. You have scratched, clawed, and fought your way to the top. Don't ever stop, because there's always somebody else who's willing to take your place. They may not be as good as you, they may not be as hungry as you, they may not have the mana deep in here as badly as you do, but they're always there. So you feel confident. You be willing to put in the work tonight that they won't, so tomorrow you accomplish what they can't. And turn the heaters on in the gym. Now, let's party. Finish your week strong, start your week strong. Just do whatever you can to make sure that you're getting the job done in a strong way on any day that ends with Y.
I like to push myself because you guys know with leg day, you got to get your adrenaline up, your intensity up. You got to get going. You got to test your mind. You got to test your will. You got to test your mettle. And we're always looking for inspiration, motivation to get us through.
It's a very late night workout here in the West Coast Iron Paradise. And I got to get it in where I can fit it in these days. I've been on daddy duty all weekend. No sleep.
Putting in work. Big dogs eat. Little crying puppies stay on the porch.
It's Saturday night and the Eagle has landed. It feels so good to be home. I just got back from China, an incredible trip. Now right now, my boys, my colleagues, my friends are trying to give me shit. They're saying, let's get dressed tonight. Let's go out to all the Golden Globes parties. I said, I'm not going to the Golden Globes parties. They said, why not? You just got back from China. I said, why not? I said, because we got work to do. This is my party right here. This is my Golden Globes party.
This week off, right? Hardest workers in the world.
All right, kicking this week off.
Focus! Right.
Put it down in this gym.
I'm the guy who was evicted at 15, as you guys know. By 23, I had $7 in my pocket. I value a hard-earned dollar.
Train hard, stay strong, and above all else, get that ass back to work. Here we go.
All right, here we are. It's very late Thursday night from the Iron Paradise. We just wrapped a hardcore workout. It was nice and intense.
This is what we call therapy, iron therapy.
Focus!
Do not go gentle into that dark night. And
it is reflective of a spirit that we have. We may get knocked down, may get our ass kicked, but we don't go gentle.